Welcome back. Today we are going to perform experiment number 4, which is three-phase power measurement. And we are going to use three-phase power supply for the first time. So first, let us get acquainted with this three-phase power supply and then we'll start the experiment.
We have two different three-phase power supply available to us. One is this 110 volt, another is 415 volt. Now, the power supply we have is a three-phase four-wire power supply. So basically, we have a star connected power supply and that star point is available to us through this neutral terminal. And RYB, these are the three-phase voltages. So if we see the voltage between N and any of those phases, say RY or B, we are going to see the phase voltage. And if we look at the voltage between any two of those phases, for example, let's say we are seeing voltage between RY, we are going to see the line voltage. Now this 110 volt mentioned over here is actually line voltage. So we'll measure through multimeter and we'll also see the waveform through oscilloscope. But before that, let's try to understand from where we are getting this power supply. Now the power supply to this board is coming through underground cables, which are kept at that trench on the floor that you are seeing. And from that, those cables are coming to the back of this power supply board. And finally, it is connected to an MCB here. And one more set of MCBs are connected here for double protection. And then we actually have fuse on the front side. And after that, we are getting this power supply available to us. Now let's try to measure this phase voltage and line voltages which are available to us. So for this experiment number 4, we are going to use 110 volt power supply. So let's see how much voltage we are getting. So the arrangement we have done is that we have taken wires from those terminals and we are going to connect our multimeter to see the voltage between different terminals. So as you can see, first we are connecting between neutral terminal and B, and the voltage we are getting is around 60 volt. And we'll now connect between neutral and other phases. So it is between neutral and Y and we are getting around 60, and neutral and R, again we are getting is around 59.1. So these three are very close to each other. Now let's try to see the voltage between two phases. So basically we are trying to measure the line voltage. So we are measuring between B and Y, and how much we are getting? It is 103. And if we measure between R and Y, we are getting around 103. So these are the line voltages which are root 3 times the phase voltages. And now I am going to show you how those line to line voltage and phase voltages looks like in oscilloscope, so that you can see their phase differences between line to line voltages, between line to line and phase voltages, and between phase to phase voltages. So all those things you can see very clearly in the oscilloscope. In this arrangement, we have connected oscilloscope probes across the different line to line and phase voltages. So let's see what those connections are. This oscilloscope has 4 probes and we have connected 3 line to line voltages in this red, green and blue color, and 1 phase voltage in magenta color. So here you can see. So this red one and this one, green and this blue, these are line to line voltages, and this is the magenta color which is showing you the phase voltage. Now what you can observe in the scope, that all the line to line voltages, their amplitudes are same, but they are phase shifted by 120 degree. For example, if you look at this green, its starting is after zero crossing of this waveform. So zero crossing of this waveform is at this instant, and after 120 degree, because this to this is 180 degree. So after 120 degree, this green waveform is starting, and after 120 degree of the green waveform, the blue waveform is starting. So basically all these three line to line voltages, they have same amplitude, but they are 120 degree phase shifted. And what is the phase shift between the phase voltage and line to line voltage? So if you look at this, this will be close to 30 degree. Now we have made the arrangement so that we can see three phase voltages and one line voltages. So let's see how it looks like in the oscilloscope. So if you follow the color code, so right now we have connected it such a way that the red color waveform is showing us VRN, and green is showing VYN, blue is showing VBN, and magenta is showing VRY, which is the line to line voltage. So what you can observe here is that all these phase voltages, these are having same amplitude, but these are 120 degree shifted, and the line voltage is having higher amplitude, which is root 3 times, and there is a phase difference between line voltage and phase voltage that we have seen earlier. Now we are going to show you how to connect this Gang Rheostat, and Mr. Dhananjay Haldar is going to make the connection for you. So first, what you do, you take two short wires, short length wire, and twist one of the common side and put it. So which side we are going to short? We'll be shorting the sides A, B, C, because these are the fixed point of the rheostat. So as per your circuit diagram, we'll be shorting this A, B, C through two short wires, and then we'll make the connection for the variable points. Okay, so now we are going to connect this red wire to A1, the yellow wire to B1, and the blue wire to C1. So now one important point you can note down is that actually you have total four number of rheostat here, but we are using only three of them because we are connecting them to form a three phase load. So this D and D1, which is the fourth rheostat, that we are not using. And how do we vary the rheostat value? So there is a handle on this side, we rotate it, and there is a sliding point inside, so that slides equally for all these three rheostat, and that's how all their values are varied equally, and that's how we are creating balanced loading condition. Now let's try to understand the circuit arrangement and we'll see how to connect. So if you look from the left hand side, this 110 volt 3 phase power supply is coming, and then we have this TPST, which is triple pole single throw. And then there is a voltmeter connected here, there are two wattmeter, and there are three ammeters over there, and finally this is the Gang Rheostat. So for your ease of understanding, we have used colored wires for making the connection. So as you can see, this red wire is connected to R, yellow is connected to Y, and blue colored wire is connected to B phase. And these three wires are taken to the TPST. Now let's try to understand how to make connection from this side. So first, if you look at the circuit diagram, we will be connecting a voltmeter between R and Y phase. So this is this voltmeter which is connected between Y and R phase, and in the other side, so if you look at from this side, this wattmeter is to be connected. So this M terminal of wattmeter will be connected to R phase. So this is that connection, you can see wattmeter. So from R phase, it is connected to the M terminal, then M, C terminals are shorted, and from the load terminal of the wattmeter, it is going to an ammeter, and from the other side of the ammeter, it is connected to the Gang Rheostat. Next, we are going to connect for this phase. So this is already done. So here from Y phase, we have to connect to the V terminal of wattmeter 1. So this is the connection. So from this Y phase, one wire is going to the V terminal of W1, and again from Y phase one wire should be connected to the V terminal of W2. So which one is W2? This is W2, and as you can see, one wire is coming from Y phase and it is connected to W2's V terminal. And then there is an emitter connected from the Y phase, and finally it should be connected to the Gang Rheostat. So this is that connection from the Y phase. One wire we have connected it to the emitter, and from other side of the emitter it is connected to the Gang Rheostat. So Y phase connection is done and we are left with B phase. So if you see here, from B phase we will be connecting to wattmeter W2. So this is the B phase, and it is connected to this M terminal of wattmeter, MC shorted, and from the L terminal of wattmeter W2 we are connecting it to an emitter, and other side of the emitter it is going to the Gang Rheostat. So this is how the complete connection is done. Now we are going to take one set of readings, but before taking the reading we must ensure that the power supply that we are getting is balanced and proper. So let's see. So using the multimeter, we are first trying to see what is the voltage that we are getting across RY. So it is VRY, we are getting around 101.7 volt. Now we will check between R and B, we are getting approximately the same value. Now we will check between Y and B, and this is around 102. So these are almost balanced. Of course you don't get 100% balance scenario. And now we will take one set of reading. So this is one set of reading with maximum rheostat values. These are the ratings, and you can take few more readings by varying the rheostat. But while reducing the rheostat, make sure that you don't reduce the resistance value too much, because there is a current limit, current rating of the rheostat, we should not exceed that. If you want to create unbalanced loading condition, you can use three different rheostat. So now we are connecting the capacitor load, and we'll be creating again a balanced loading condition. So we'll connect three equal valued capacitor, and we'll connect them in star. So for total three capacitor, we have six terminals, and three terminals we are going to short to form that star point, and from the remaining three terminal we'll connect to RY and B phase. And now we are going to take one set of reading for the balanced capacitive case. So first we'll turn on the power supply, and then we'll close the TPST, and we are going to take readings. We are going to take one set of readings. So let's try to see what reading we have got. So as you can see, the wattmeter is still fluctuating, so we'll wait for it. And in the meantime, let's see what is the current. So as you can see in the display, current is around 1.4 ampere. It is also 1.4 ampere. This is around 1.45 ampere. And let's see what is the wattmeter reading. So you can see from the zero line, it has gone to the negative side. So W2 is giving us negative value. And what we are getting here? So what you can observe carefully is that both the wattmeter are giving us same value, but one is giving in the positive direction, whereas the other one is giving on the negative direction. This is the one set of reading is done.